What do you guys disagree about?
Paul, what about my speech did you not like? Because there was stuff in there that I knew that you had to be pushing back on mentally.
Your comparison of the United States to Greece is unambiguously, comprehensively, and holistically wrong.
Okay.
America is not Greece.
Not yet.
America will not be Greece. Greece is part of monetary union, has given up monetary sovereignty, and therefore does not control its own destiny. Greece has not borrowed in its own currency. It is borrowed in the currency of the monetary union. America is the global reserve currency. We have borrowed in our own currency. There is a natural demand for assets denominated in our currency because we're the global reserve currency. And if there is a putative shortfall at some juncture in the funding of our fiscal deficits, Mr. Bernanke has a printing press and he gets his ink for free.
But, okay, now let me just say this. That's perfectly comfortable. I can buy the argument, but that is not without risk and not without peril. It will give us inflation. It will hurt the dollar. That will not be a fun period, I don't think. Printing has not historically been a wonderful thing. In large quantities, I guess you'd say. Maybe you're thinking smaller quantities, only a few hundred billion here, a few hundred billion there.
You can always take a good idea too far. And monetary printing is not a risk proposition in the tail of the distribution. And we're not living in the tail of the distribution. From the standpoint of its inflationary portent, it can obviously have a softening effect on the dollar, and that can be a bit of a negative terms of trade shock for us. But I would put myself in Rosie's camp predominantly on the inflation process in the United States. So I simply don't think that we'll be in an extremis sort of situation.
Are people going to let us borrow money forever?
Do you buy the argument that the long-term trajectory of the fiscal situation is a realistic outcome? So something has to change.
No, I'm a big believer in the concept of that which is unsustainable will not be sustained.
So what stops it?
What stops it will be the democratic process reaching a democratic solution, which is changing the social contract that we have right now between the young and the old, and the poor and the rich, and we will rejigger the distribution of our income in our economy so as that everybody sitting on this stage and most everybody sitting in this room will assume a great deal more personal responsibility for their retirement age and will not be financed with a regressive tax on poor young people called the payroll tax. So we will, as a society, do the right thing.
Willingly, without being forced.
We agree on that. I think there's a 75%, call it 80% chance, that we willingly do this. Because to me, not doing it is horrific. I mean, even if it's benign just printing money is not a good thing. I think we willingly do this, but we agree. We don't become Greece.
What do you disagree with, David?
Well,
and we don't just have to pick on John. You can pick on Martin if you like,
no,
or Louis, or Paul.
I feel badly picking on the host. But
why should you? I mean, join in.
I guess I'd probably disagree with Martin, and maybe I would probably disagree with the whole premise that we're in some sort of fiscal crisis. I don't think we're in a fiscal crisis. You'd have to define what a crisis is. But it is the problem of the deficits becoming increasingly structural, And it is imperative that we start to do something about it now.